How many of the 68 total chocolate bars of... Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh. Hi, treasures. Please like and subscribe.
Pretty much all of them.
Thank you.
I don't have a sweet tooth. Flop era. Can you address why people are counting how many chocolate bars I bought? No, honestly, I don't pick up on that. Ask me how many bags of Puffs chips are left. That might be a different story. I had a few bags of the Puffs, that's for sure. But.
But what?
The chocolate bars, actually. Especially when I'm sick, like, even that ice cream I showed you a picture of, we still have some in the freezer. Like, it's a small sundae and it's just too sweet. I'm not really craving sweet things right now. A plus. Stop thirsting over very many, plus. I just find it bizarre her audience calls me chins. Like, what? I don't know. It's, like, weird that, like, an entire 4,000 people are projecting this, like, weird, you know? I'm also a salty carb girl, not a sweets girl. Your husband, on the other hand. Yeah, same here. Like, my husband, Stella, loves sweets. But me, I love salty things. I love it. Which both are not healthy and extremes, you know? Sunshine. Well, things have to change, you know? That was not a healthy time in my life, that's for sure.
Yep.
I had very little self-respect. Put it together. Actually, that's a good combination. And usually, like, after I eat something salty, then I'll crave, like, something kind of desserty, but it takes a while. For some reason, like, like, whenever, like, every time I go to a family dinner at my mom's, they always have, like, an array of desserts after. But they, like, eat dessert, like, maybe 10, 15 minutes after dinner, and I'm just like, no, I always bring dessert home. Remember that one time I was on a diet, and I had cake riding with me in the passenger seat, and I like pulled over and stuffed my face with it, and I made a video crying that I did that. Go to Thailand, will you and Salim kiss in public? No, because we're still Muslim, flop. So that's why it's looked down upon in this society, because it's a Islamic country. I don't know, I don't feel it necessary to show PDA to like prove anything, you know?
Right, sure.
I mean, of course I want to sometimes just jump on him and kiss him, but I was quite shocked by FFG's face reveal. You guys have never seen her before? Is that photo? She looks like she had a dent in her forehead. I don't know if it was like lighting creating shadow. I think actually she was like something happened. She was like hit with her ex who was abusive. I think that's what it's from, but I'm not 100% sure. Yeah, well, the thing is like, same thing with pizza's chat. Like, people are gonna try to trigger you no matter what. Like, you can't avoid that. No matter how much you rage about it, no matter how, it just makes it worse. Like, it just makes, like, you're giving the people who try to trigger you to rage what they want. That's what I realized. You know, so it's like, but some people, like, they prey on people who have, like, emotional instabilities, you know, and are easily triggered. Even if you're left-handed? That's a good question, Golden Girl. I think so, yeah. I don't know, maybe Muslims show affection in other countries all the time. I don't think PDA, Sunshine, no, it's not common at all. Wait, you'll see, like, it tells you not to do it. A screenshot, and I was like, yikes. No offense, but...
Okay, sure.
Mimi. I don't know. Just whatever. The right hand. I have a question about the cultural pretty much I forget. I don't know, maybe he didn't. I'm asking questions. Like, that's why I open my comments, because, like, I don't mind, like, answering constructive comments or questions. It's just, like, I don't know, it's fun, kind of. And, like, a mixture, like, of different audience. And it's, like, a way to attract, like, different, like, new people, too. Traffic to your channel and stuff. I have to come up with clever TikToks because I can't. Do we do a Dr. Wayne Bees? No. She's obsessed with you and now she's milking Hanging with Shannon for all the views, just like everything else she does. Yeah, she has to like just, and like, exactly. Exactly, Sabre. I did not weigh in, no. This fly has been harassing me. There's always like one fly.
One too many.
That's the thing when it's like summer year round, there's always flies and bugs and stuff. So open in the bedroom, that's why the flies come in. They were asking me, there's a central, in a lot of my videos you see the central air pad on the wall and there's like vents. We don't have an AC unit, it's a central air. Salish. Well, Salah's father, a little bit. Do you live in a slumdog millionaire? No, we live in a pretty normal flat apartment for our area, actually. It's pretty nice. It's a newer building, actually. I know, like, people, things are just, like, different than in, you know, Canada. Obviously, the apartments are a bit different in that, but, you know, yeah, I mean, I've seen a lot worse from the outside looking. And you left Canada to live in poverty? There's no poverty in Kuwait. So, no, poverty would be like living in like a tent with like dirty, no water, no food. There are actual, like, it's actually insulting to actually impoverished people to claim that we're living in poverty. Like, if you live in poverty, you don't even have you don't have two TVs, you don't have, you know what I mean? So it's just, they're like actual impoverished people. There are a lot of them. Yeah, it's really sad. We downsized our house. It was just too much to look after. Yeah, for sure. That villa was way too much for me to look after, like, with my fitness level and just like my mental health and everything, like, hysterectomy replacement bees. I'm sure in the future that will be a thing, like uterine transplants. It is, but it's like not normalized yet. A message from someone saying they have been sleeping with Sulla. Yeah. I think I answered you. There you go, flop era. Talking about putting uterus in trans women so you never know. Just recently posted a message from someone saying they have been sleeping with Sulla.
I had to hear that yeah. Again. Okay.
I think I answered you. There you go, flop era. Talking about putting uterus in trans women so you never know. Really, Mimi? Oh, I didn't know that. Wet brain? That's a term I never heard before. You have a wet brain. I think I like it. Just in general for dumb people. That's not very nice, is it? Being nice is hard. Being nice to people you don't want to be nice to is hard. But I happen to enjoy when my boyfriend locks me in a room for a bit. Yeah. I'm totally fine, guys. There's no dark arc. There's no, you know, conspiracy of him kidnapping me. Anyway, you can't kidnap the willing. You know. Hold me against my will, Sulla. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. What brain is a medical condition alcoholics get? Oh, I never heard of that. Him kidnapping me. Anyway, you can't kidnap the willing. You know. hold me against my will, Salah. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. What brain is a medical condition alcoholics get? Oh, I never heard of that. But yes, she definitely needs a life if she's, I don't know. I mean, people probably don't know. Like, you know, they don't know. The only people who really know our situation is us, Sala and I. So everyone else is just creating rumors and whatever else. But for all people know, like, they don't know us, right? So whatever, let them talk. Hi, Jen Marie. A jealous person. I try not to be like so jealous and controlling and stuff like that, all the toxic stuff, but like I'm very aware of, like, he and I are both very aware of where we go, what we do. Our things are open to one another. We have each other's passwords. Like, there's no secrets. So yeah. I chase the rainbow. We're not really talking right now. Stop kink shaming. She's consenting. Prince Beezer. I look so much calmer there. Yeah, it's a definitely different life for me, Taste the Rainbow. I think, you know, if I just focus on positivity and working hard on myself and everything, really trying to battle my demons, because I know people think I came here to escape them, but no, they don't. You don't just leave them behind, you know? And also, I think, like, this is a general question. I answered it in the comments, but basically, like, why didn't you just use your civil ID at the clinic, not your passport? Because I don't have a civil ID yet. It takes time, like, to actually come in the, like, you have, it takes time for it to come. You know, like, it's not just, imagine, like, when you're applying for a passport or an identity card, and so anywhere in the world, it doesn't, you don't just go in and they give you a laminated piece of paper, here you go. You know, it's not like that. It's not like a membership club card from Costco, you know? Like, it's a government thing. So, but yeah, that's basically what's happening with that. I was surprised by how cheap it was for me to get healthcare. Now, I don't know if I needed an operation or something, if that would be the same thing. I know OHIP does cover emergencies in foreign countries. If you look up OHIP, you can get reimbursed for emergency care. And I know people are gonna go, well, you hate Canada. I don't hate Canada. I don't mean it that way. I was fed up with my life, well, like, with living there, yes. But I do still pay my taxes. The ones I owe, like, I pay them in installments, so that's being taken care of. It's not like I moved here to avoid paying taxes. But when I do become a resident here, I won't have to pay taxes. Like, it'll give me a good break for, like, you know, a good couple of years of just being able to catch up on what I already owe. And I'm only telling you guys this because you already know my business. So
there you go.
That to me is a benefit for sure. And it's a cheaper, living here is cheaper, and without paying taxes, it will give me a really good opportunity to catch up on things, you know? Please tell me you took one whole pill 2 times a day now. Jen Marie, we specifically asked the pharmacist. So if you see these pills, they have little grooves in them for a reason. Like, they have the groove to be, they're split. They're easily split in half. I don't know if it's to make it easier on your system, but it's supposed, I'm supposed to take one half every, basically every 12, like twice a day. So that's what the pharmacist said. So yeah, that's the dosing I'm supposed to take for myself. Will your family come to visit you in Kuwait? No. I don't know. I was talking to them about that. They were open to it. But, you know, I mean, knock on wood, I will see them again. Yeah, it's, I don't mean, I'm never not going back to Canada ever. I just mean for a while, you know, instead of every having to come back and back every 3 months, because the trip is very hard on me, and it's also, you know, it's pricey to go back and forth so many times. You know, so it's, but it's more that the trip is just very hard to do. It's such a hard trip. I don't know. I just don't know how people do it. It's just exhausting, you know?
Love you, treasures, and I will see you on the next one. Remember,
who knows? Maybe in like a beautiful. Few months I'll feel like going back to visit my family, but I don't know. Are you going to hang out with Stella's family a lot during Ramadan? Is it traditional to spend lots of time with family? Yeah, probably. Yeah, friends and family. We actually have plans later tonight to go out, but I'm going to see how I feel. I'm starting to feel like better, but I'll see how I feel.
I'm not sure I believe that.
Are those pills banana flavored? I wish, Mimi. Remember the banana penicillin? Much different here, yeah.